Hey, my name is Ben, and I teach you how to write Udemy shaders from scratch. Today, we're going to do this lava distortion and pulsating effect. All right, so to get started on this effect, the first thing we want to do is have two textures to sample. One is the main texture, and one is our distortion texture. So as you can see here, I already have the distortion here, and the distortion is T. We also want to have two sets of UVs. So I'm going to quickly change this to a float 4, and I'm going to copy this. And I'm going to make two sets of UVs. One will be XY, that will be for our main texture, and ZW will be for our distortion. So to quickly check to see if it's been working, we can manipulate our UVs with this texture. And let's just kind of add on one of these textures. And here I will test by displaying the other color. We'll just quickly call it color 2. I'll rename it later. Actually, no, let's do it properly now. Distortion. And then instead of UV here, it should be XY. That's for our main texture. And our second set of UVs is ZW for distortion. Cool. So as you can see, it's working now. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to use the red and green channel from the distortion to distort the color. So we're going to move the distortion sampling first, right? Because we need to grab these values out. A very simple way to do distortion, and this is of course going to be mathematically incorrect, but we can just kind of do it just to take a look, is to add or multiply on this red and green. So if we did that, we'll do add first. What it'll look like, it's like this. As you can see, it's been distorted wildly already. So maybe this is adding on too much. So let's do a distortion intensity. And this will be a float. We'll set it to 1. So if we set this to 0, we'll see no distortions. I'm going to also change this back to 1. And as we set a little bit, now we can start to see it distort. Now, notice this bug. This is the bug that I'm talking about. As we increase it, it seems to be kind of going off into the corner. So a very simple way to solve this issue is because the distortion is actually going from 0 to 1, the red and green channel are both going from 0 to 1, what we want to do is going from minus 1 to 1. That's why, that way, whenever we add it on with a multiplier, some of the values can go negative, right? So we want some of the UV values to go, it's possible for some of the values to go negative. So let's do 2 times 2, minus 1. After we do that, whenever we change this distortion, now you can see that it is actually not shifting or flowing in place. Okay, let's tune this so that it looks a little bit better. Maybe even that is too high. Maybe 0.034. Let's have a look there. Yeah, even that is pretty intense, right? You can kind of see the effect happening. Cool. So the next thing we want to do is we're now using the red and green channel of our distort. Let's resample this and actually create a highlight effect with that last channel, the blue channel. We'll call it, we'll call it heat. Can't really think of a good name right now. Heat works. So distortion, and then the next value will be heat. So we're going to get rid of the times 2 minus 1, and our heat value is just going to be our blue channel dot B. So if we return our heat, it would look like this. Cool. And what we're going to do is we're going to use this heat and we're just going to simply multiply against the color. And then we'll return the color out. Now it looks like it kind of got dark in some places. That's okay. So what we're going to do is do a times heat. 1 plus heat. Right. So now our heat will be wherever you can start to see some spots are really glowing out. In fact, we're going to put this back. Test this times 2 minus 1. There we go. Now we can see some spots are being dark and some spots are being hot, right? Because we want to kind of create this effect going underneath it, right? So let's go ahead and do that. Now this is getting quite long, so I'm going to move this out. In fact, I'm going to rewrite color. Going to be equal to, and we're going to create a ramp effect. I think a ramp effect will look a little bit better in this case, right? So a ramp effect will be a pow color, maybe a 2 times our heat effect. All right, there we go. Of course, don't forget the plus 1. So I'm going to do heat plus 1. I'm going to bracket that off as well. All right. And now, why did I do a ramp effect instead? I think that will give us that that contrast that we're probably looking for here. So let's change this into a ramp. Ramp. So as we go lower, we can probably get this really, it's almost hot and desaturated, but higher will give us this extreme char-like looking effect, right? And probably in changing this value would help a lot too with that intensity. So yeah, we can add that as well. We can add an intensity. And I think instead of adding it on, I'm just going to multiply it on. I think we need a little bit of a midpoint. So that's why I did the plus 1. Maybe we can do plus 0.5. Let's see how that looks. Yeah, I think having a little bit of a midpoint helps. We can also make that into a variable, but I think this makes it work quite well. All right, so the next thing we need is animation. We need some animation parameters. We'll call it animParam. This will be a vector. We're going to use all 4. I'll put zeros for now. Animation params will be a float 4. And what I want to do is for the ZW or for the distortion, I want to add on animation params XY times a speed. So our speed will just be time. Oops. Dot Y. Then we're going to do the same thing here, but instead of XY, we're going to do ZW. What that will do is it'll allow us to kind of control the distortion with this first value. So if we put, let's say, something like 0.1, we can start to see a bit of distortion effect. But if we put a value here, we can start to see this effect. It's kind of oscillating the hot colors of our lava. So maybe we'll do negative minus 0.1. And it doesn't seem like, oh, it looks like you can kind of see this texture and it's kind of moving along. But if you do the wave, the distortion, it's almost very hard to notice that texture. So maybe we'll do 0.2. It's actually still noticeable. So So I went ahead and changed this back to heat plus one because I just think it looks a little bit better that way. You can still see the effect of the lava kind of changing in color. Perhaps this is a time to, you know, change up the intensity. Maybe that will help make sell the effect and lower the ramp. All right, so I made a couple of changes. I added this sine wave to this heat. It created that oscillating effect, that on and off, as you can see, but everything else is pretty much the same. Oh, I also moved the heat math inside the POW. I think it gives it a much better effect. Cool. So if you guys like what you see, and if you guys think this is something that's helpful to you, please like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys next time.